Good morning, Wildcats, and welcome to our first show of HBWN. I'm Cole Brothers. On today's show, we take a look at some new technology with the construction and design team, not to mention our very own television production team went above and beyond in a recent competition. Today's October 1st, 2013, and you're watching Har-Ber Wildcat News. Our construction class is lucky to be able to provide real-world experience to young professionals every day. With the implementation of their new CNC machine, preparation for the real-world construction industry has improved tremendously. Jared brings us the story.
Har-Ber High School Construction Design has implemented new technology, a CNC machine.
CNC stands for Computer Numerically Controlled. So it takes a computer to actually operate the piece of equipment. Our specific piece is a CNC router. It's going to be used in our cabinet and casework program. It's also going to be used to collaborate with physics, geometry, and other departments because of the correlation between all the mathematics and what we're going to use the piece of equipment for.
With new technology, how is this going to improve student employment?
One of our industry partners, Multicraft Contractors, has 10 different types of CNC equipment in their facility. So students learning this kind of technology will be able to take that out and apply it in the workplace.
With such great potential, how are students feeling about the new machine?
I'll be one step ahead when I go to school and college. Not many people my age will know how to use this machine. And it looks good, and it's good for going into it, the workforce, and having that knowledge in mind.
Common Core is a new addition to the school district. How is this helping framework throughout the school?
Well, there's a big tie in Common Core between mathematics, science, the STEM part of the education. The mathematics alone that are utilized in the CNC equipment with physics, geometry, calculus, all those things allow us to collaborate with those different departments. So there should be a huge correlation between those, which ties us back to the Common Core philosophy.
Clearly, the CNC machine not only benefits the construction department, but students in the entire school. For HBWN, this is Jared Gabriel.
With such high education, students are sure to be fully prepared for the real world. Right after the break, we'll learn how seniors made the Rotunda their own personal dance floor. Stay tuned, HBWN will be right back.
PSAT is a test. It helps students prepare for life outside of high school.
Taking the PSAT can help students by
preparing them to take the SAT,
dándole la oportunidad de ganar becas,
receive information from colleges,
begin college and career planning,
to help them increase academic skills necessary for college level work.
I often have students ask, what is the PSAT and why is it important for me to take it?
Taking the PSAT will allow you to see your full potential,
which will give you an easier path to college
and begin your transition into the real world.
Each year, more than 3.5 million students take the first step in the transition by taking the PSAT, which gives them the opportunity to qualify for the National Merit Scholarship.
This test is important because it can help you, the student, become eligible for the National Merit Scholarship.
On October 16th, both students from Springdale High School and Har-Ber High School will take the PSAT. Will you be there?
I'll be there.
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 Will you?
Welcome back to HBWN. Recently at Har-Ber, the seniors surprised everyone with their excellent dance moves. If I must say so myself, I was very impressed. Jade Nash has the story.
This year at Har-Ber High School, the seniors decided to surprise the school in a unique way.
A flash mob is like a choreographed dance that spontaneously happens at some time of the day.
This has been a Har-Ber tradition for many years now. But why is it so important for the seniors to demonstrate this to the rest of the student body?
It's something that as seniors, you know, we want to lead and be an example and have school spirit and really pump up the juniors and sophomores. So I think it was just something to show that, you know, we're proud.
Senior pranks are also a tradition here at Har-Ber High School. So what else can we expect from the seniors this year?
We have many surprises for Har-Ber this year.
Well, whatever the seniors have up their sleeves, it's sure to be a surprise. For HBWN, I'm Jade Nash.
Wow, who knew the seniors had that in them? In other news, HBWN was recently honored to make Arkansas history. It was a special year for everyone, and I'm honored to know that our names will forever be associated with the Hall of Fame. Johnner has the story.
For the past school year, HBTV has been competing for the Arkansas Scholastic Press Association.
Arkansas Scholastic Press Association, or we call it ASPA, is an event held for all high school students every year. So students come from all over Arkansas to compete in on-site competitions. It's all for broadcast students, and they compete to be the best in the state.
Students have been competing for the top prize 3 years in a row.
The past 3 years, they had won the best news program in the state of Arkansas. So this past year was their fourth consecutive year, and they were inducted into the Hall of Fame.
Winning the Hall of Fame have been a few school circumstances, but Har-Ber was willing to win it.
Most classes have about 20 to 30 people in a news program. We had 12. So to have an honor like that bestowed upon our kids is just, it goes above and beyond what we could ever imagine.
Clearly, Har-Ber had a big process. How did the students feel about it?
We just didn't get there magically, just wave a wand or something like that. It was a big process. It took a lot of hard work and dedication.
For Har-Ber being number one in state, what is their goal for this year?
We don't want to just win the award and just sink back down. We want to go for a repeat, I guess is what you could call it. We want to stay up there at the top. And once you're the best, the hardest thing is staying up there because everyone else is chasing you. But that's our goal for this year. We want to stay up there at the top.
Though the future is uncertain for HBTV, Har-Ber is going to have a special year. For HBWN, I'm John Learned.
Everyone here at HBWN would like to give a big thank you to all our followers who made this possible. It's something that will live on forever at Har-Ber and something that I will always remember. Well, that's all for today. Be sure to stay tuned for your morning announcements. For HBWN, I'm Cole Brothers. Shake and bake.